Sound Ah is a portal to higher consciousness. Human beings who seek God will look to the stars. This causes an elongation of the throat and vocal cords, a position conducive to producing the sound Ah. Ah in Hebrew is Aleph and He. Aleph meaning the most high or divine. He means the window of the breath. Ah means the window of the breath that lets in the divine. Perhaps this is why meditation masters claim that meditating on the sound Ah connects one with spirit. Ah is the sound we make to accept medicine. Medicine flies under the flag of the caduceus because it originates with medicinal entheogenic drugs that caused spiritual journey. Reaching higher consciousness means reaching higher states of awareness. Every time our consciousness grows, when we become more aware of something, we say, Ah.
The gust we shall return.
Even when thinking or speaking about divinity, we are forced to say Ah, because the word is ingrained in all of our words for God. Laughter, our greatest expression of joy, is an experience of spiritual growth. That is why laughter is pronounced Ha, 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 more recently as L-O-L or L-O-L. Ha, 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 L-O-L reflects perfectly Jehovah Elohim, both gateways to divinity or joy. Humans intuitively understand that laughter is the best medicine. Higher consciousness lies in the stars. Looking at the stars forces us to say Ah because of the position of our neck and throat. Monty Python and the Holy Grail is the search for an artifact that grants powers of Christ. The men encounter a white rabbit, then enter the rabbit's hole, where they find writing on a wall by
Joseph of Arimathea,
who tells them,
"Find the Holy Grail in the castle of
Triangle, square, pentagon, hexagon, heptagon, octagon, nanogon, decagon. One of these shapes is not like the others. The O in octagon is pronounced Ah. The Great Pyramid is an octagram, just like Akhenaten or Amun or Amun-Ra. That is why our old shamanistic medicine men told us to meditate and say
Ah.
The Stargate of Ah is the opening of the mouth to say Ah, so as to receive medicine from your witch doctor or shaman. Shaman were Ah-men. The modern shaman is a doctor. While shaman were both medicine men and spirit guides, the doctor is also both medicine man and spirit guide. Doctors oversee our entrance into life on Earth. They help to prolong our stay on this physical plane. Then they oversee the exit of our soul into the next realm. The doctor, without even knowing it, is the spirit guide of today, which is why they are associated with the caduceus. Humans are hardwired to know that Ah takes us on a spiritual journey. That is why if someone were to tell you to say Ah, you would immediately think of a doctor.
by the priests of Isis and Osiris in the days of the pharaohs of Egypt.
Hello. Before I became the omnipotent and all-powerful ruler of Oz, I was a magician. You may be asking yourself why at this moment, at the time of your victory, I would show up. I just wanted you to understand how I managed to bring this off.
Over the rainbow or into color is a metaphor for stepping into the light, being able to see new parts of the energy spectrum, becoming aware of new information that has been floating around us all along. Dorothy steps into the light of color, her metaphorical ascension. She gets there by journeying through a metaphorical wormhole, an earthbound wormhole impersonator, Tornado. She steps into the land of enlightenment. The sound we make when we suddenly become enlightened is ah. That's why the lord of the land of enlightenment is Oz. Christopher Lloyd is Oz in The Witches of Oz, lord of the land of color, clarity, or enlightenment. He plays this character in Who Framed Roger Rabbit, where our protagonist journeys a tunnel wormhole and enters into the land of light, the lord of that land being Christopher Lloyd.
Since I've had Toontown under my jurisdiction, my goal has been to rein in the insanity.
Macaulay Culkin journeys the wormhole tunnel, then becomes engulfed in and enters the land of color, traversing the rainbow, stepping into the spectrum. The lord of this land is Christopher Lloyd. He is the lord of the land of color because he is Zeus, Jupiter, the land over the rainbow. The Wizard of Oz is strangely connected to green octagrams that decorate his home of Emerald City. Ground Zero is the location of Emerald City in The Wiz, and is home to a giant green octagon, the base of One World Trade Building. Christopher Lloyd's Oz movie takes place in New York City. Ground Zero is bordered by two parallel streets called West and Greenwich, or Greenwich, Greenwich of the West, another overt Oz resonance. The octagram is worn by Oz Lloyd in the movie DuckTales, where he hovers above an airplane that crashes into two towers, which then collapse. The ensuing scene eerily reminiscent of 9/11, immediately after the carnage he lands atop a pyramid. Octagons are seen prominently on display as the wizard conquers flight to become lord of the sky. Sky god Zeus is an eagle in myth. Zeus, as god of all gods, is synonymous with Egyptian god of all gods, Horus, both avian sky gods who rest on mountaintops. Zeus atop Mount Olympus is the same as Horus atop the pyramid. They are both the same god. On the dollar bill, they are portrayed in green, Zeus eagle and Horus atop the pyramid, which is concave and thus octagonal, or a green octagon, surrounding our declarations of monotheistic authority. Christopher Lloyd is Zeus. That's why his tunnel accesses an observatory of heaven that sits on top of a mountain and sports a giant green octagon, on the underside of which is a large mural centered around an image of Zeus. Macaulay Culkin is sent into the land of color while standing on an octagram. Moments ago, he passed through this tunnel that leads to the observatory. Above his head is a giant mural focused around Lloyd, paralleling the observatory's mural focused around Zeus.
omnipotent and all-powerful ruler of Oz.
Since I've had Toontown under my jurisdiction,
I am the Pagemaster.
The observatory's origins are less than innocent. Designed by John C. Austin, an architect exclusively devoted to constructing free Masonic temples, he is responsible for the Hollywood Masonic Temple, the Shriners Masonic Auditorium, and LA City Hall, an obvious phallic obelisk honoring Horus and featured on the cover of a movie the trailer of which foreshadowed the Dark Knight Theater shootings. Suspended from the ceiling on the underside of the octagon is the observatory's focal piece, a Foucault pendulum. It rests underneath the mural of Zeus. These scientific devices measure the rotation of the Earth. Each Foucault pendulum will take a specific number of hours to complete one rotation, depending on where on Earth it is located. For the location of the Griffith Observatory, the rotation period is 42 hours. Thus, we have 42 suspended from an image of Zeus, conjoined to an octagon. Considering the scenario played out with the mural of Lloyd and the Griffith Park Tunnel, and his previous Zeus associations, we can connect this Zeus green octagon to Lloyd sitting atop the Giza Octagon Stargate Pyramid in his Zeus Eagle form while wearing a green octagram, after just observing a plane crash into two towers, as one did at the revealing of the Ground Zero octagram. Aleister Crowley meditated inside the Giza octagram and channeled the divinity Awaz, pronounced Awaz, furthering the immutable connection between channeling divinity and the audible sound ah, appropriate considering the human body is anatomically designed to say ah when we look up at the stars of heaven, where we believe God to be. To meditate on and speak the word ah is to open the window for the divine spirit. The Stargate of Ah is the window that lets in the divine. When Dorothy comes home, she tells of her journey through the land of enlightenment, while quietly in the background, the divine Oz enters in through the window.
Doesn't anybody believe me?
Of course we believe you, Dorothy.
Oh, but anyway, Toto, we're home.
I bring you!
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard.